Today I'm going to deliver a lecture on linear algebra, lecture 5, on problems and theorems of subspaces by Dr. P. Ramlu, Head Department of Mathematics, MBA Government Arts and Science College, Mahunagar. Yesterday class already I discussed about the theorems and some problems of subspaces. What is subspace? How can we define subspace? That thing already we discussed yesterday. Now I am going to explain some problems and theorems of subspaces. Theorems of subspace very useful in future for entrance purpose or other things. You have to keep it in your mind or can apply in your real life. Okay. So, problem. Let R3 over R, you may write with your also, like you can use R3 over R, B vector space, W is equal to, here I am taking that R3 over R, B vector space, W equal to X, X such that X belongs to Q, is non-empty subset of, X, X such that X belongs to Q, is non-empty subset of R3, then show that W is not subset of subspace of R3 over R. So I'm here. I'm taking that W is I'm taking that W is equal to X X such that X belongs to Q. Then I want to show that W is not subspace of R3 over R. Let R3 over R be a vector space. We know that already that R3 over vector space is nothing but it satisfies all vector space properties. I am taking the W is equal to X, X is that X belongs to Q is non-empty subset of R3. So we know that for showing W is subspace of R3 over R, R3, first of all W is subset of R3. It is clear that X, X is that X belongs to Q, it is in the form of R3, that means it is in the form of R3 only. That means it is has 3 coordinates, here also 6 coordinates. Here, this set contains real number includes relation numbers, that means the subset is clearly there. So, we know that already for showing W is subspace of R3 over R, necessary subspace condition for A alpha plus D beta belongs to W, for all alpha comma beta belongs to W, and A comma belongs to right. Other way, you can take that for showing W is alpha plus W is subspace of R3. For that alpha plus beta belongs to A, and A alpha belongs to W, and that thing like A water may be A alpha belongs to W. For that for this case I want to use first theorem. Theorem 1, yesterday I have proved that A equal to root 5, alpha equal to XX is that that equal to 1, 1, 1. This is my alpha. A alpha is equal to this. I am taking that W subspace. In this W, I am taking alpha is equal to XXX, that equal to 1, 1, 1, and simply I am taking 1, 1, 1. A equal to root 5. A is belonging to field, alpha belongs to W, that means A belongs to root 5, that equal to root 5 belongs to R, alpha belonging to this set. A alpha is equal to what happened? A alpha equal to root 5, 1, 1, 1, alpha nothing but 1, 1, 1. If I multiply this root 5, root 5, root 5. But this element does not belong into W, since this root 5 does not belong to Z. Our W is equal to X, X such that X belongs to root Q. If I multiply root 5 to this number, I will get root 5, root 5, root 5. But root 5 does not belong into Q. That's why this set W is not subspace of, right? A alpha root 5, this belongs to this. Not belongs to W, therefore W is not subspace of R3 over R. Next, I want to prove that let Vn over F be a vector space, W is equal to A1 comma dot 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 An, so up to so on An, and summation Ai equal to 0, that means A1 plus A2 plus dot dot Ami equal to 0, and Ehi belongs to F. So W is equal to A1 A2 plus A that to summation I equal to 0 and AI belongs to F is non-empty subset of Vn. This is non-empty subset of Vn. Then show that W is subspace of Vn over F. given v and o plus vector space, that means it has n coordinate letter, right? I'm taking that w is equal to a1, a2, a n, summation a equal to 0, and a x belongs to f. This will do. For showing w is subspace of v, v n, w is subspace of v n, I want to take two elements in this, and a alpha comma beta like this, or u comma v belongs to this set. And you can take that a comma b belongs to in field f. I want to show that a u plus b v belong to w. So that's why I'm taking that u is equal to x1, x2 divided as xn, v is equal to y1, y2 divided as yn, such that this condition in this set, which has condition that summation a equal, that means a1, a2 divided as an equal to 0. That's why x1, u, I'm taking u is equal to x1, x2, xn, v is equal to y1, y2 divided as yn, which is nothing but x1 plus x2 plus divided as xn equal to 0, and y1 plus y2 equal to 0. That means this, if I belong to w, we satisfy this condition. If we belong to V, it satisfies this condition. Yesterday we have explained to, in lecture 4, I explained to this kind of problem. So here I am taking n tuple. Let I am taking A comma V belongs to R. A equal to what happened? A into x1, x2 divided as xn. That equal to AX1, AX2, AXN. BV equal to B into y1, y2 divided as yn. That equal to BY1, BY2 divided as BYN. AU plus BV. That equal to AX1, comma AX2, comma divided as AXN, plus BY1, comma BY2, divided as BYN. If I add these things, AX1 plus BY1, comma AX2 plus BY2, comma divided as AX plus plus BY, then what happen? AX1 plus BY1, comma AX2 plus BY2, divided as AXN plus BY1. If I add in this, I will get this element. If this element belongs to W, this element so satisfies the given condition. That means so a1 plus a2 plus data is n equal to 0. In place of an, what we have here, a1 is nothing but this, a2 is nothing but this, a1. I am considering a1 plus a2 plus a1 nothing but this, a2 nothing but this, a n nothing but this. So I am considering this, so a1 in place of a1 I am writing this, ax1 plus by1, in place of a2 I am writing here ax2 plus by2. Data as in place of an I am writing here axn plus bn. If I add both things, that is what happened, ax1 plus by1, ax2 plus by2 divided as axn. So, since vn over the vector space, all elements belong to vector, it satisfies associative abelian property, distributive property. By using all these properties, I am writing here a is common out because it is not coming easily. Why? Because if I do this thing, I want to apply associate property, I am forgetting this. Next, I want to apply abelian property, we will get ax1 plus bx2. Similarly, we can apply for all elements, abelian, associative, abelian, associative, abelian, associative, abelian. We will get, finally, we will get ax1 plus ax2 plus data axn plus by1 plus by2 data bm. Later, what we will apply distribute laws, so I can take a1 out, a common out, we will get ax1, a times x1 plus x2 data xn, b times of y1 plus y2 data ym. So, this thing already I know that by conditions, if this equal to 0, this is equal to 0, a times 0 plus b times 0, that equal to 0, therefore a1 a2 divided as an equal to 0. So this element equal to 0 then means, so au plus bb, this satisfies this condition, that's why I am taking this belong to w. For all a comma belongs to r, u comma v belongs to w, au plus bb belong to w, therefore w is subspace of, right, w is subspace of vector space vn over f. Next I problem. Prove that the set of all solutions of x, y, z belongs to set of all solutions x, y, z and the equation x plus y plus 2z is the subspace of right. Prove that set of all solution of the equation set of all solution x, y, z for and the equation x plus okay these x, y, z are the solutions of this okay is subspace of part over okay. Last lecture, I already proved that Rp over Rb is vector space, W is equal to x, y, z such that x plus y plus z, 2z equal to 0 and x, y, z belong into R. So, W equal to x, y, z such that x plus y plus 2z equal to 0 and I am taking x, y, z equal to 0. This is given W. I want to prove that this is just now already proved that. Last lecture, I proved that here 2y is there and 3z is there. In place of here, we will get that. Simply, other way, can take ax plus y plus in place of z, what we are. Just now we prove that a1 plus a2 plus a3 equal to 0, but here we have extra one condition. In place of 1, you can put 2 0 will get easily, but I will little bit explain partially. I am taking that u small u is equal to x1 x2 is that this belongs to, and So is that x1 plus 5 y1 plus 2z equal to 0. If I take any element in W, which satisfies this condition, if I take v equal to x2 plus y2 plus z2 x, or x2 y2 z2 plus w, such that this condition I am becoming sharp. AU, AU is what a times of this, that will get ax1, ay1, az1, b will be nothing but bx2, by2, bz2, that means bx2, by2, bz. If I add both things, then yx2, ax1, ay1, az1, this plus, we will add ax1 plus bx2, ay1 plus by2, az1 plus z, according to partition of two vector space, right? So I want to consider x plus 2y plus 2z, in place of x what we have this, in place of y what we have this, in place of z what we have here, 2z. I want to consider this equation, ax1 this, and so apply all properties of vector space, since R2 vector space, so I am applying here, c here, ay1 for this, I terms common out, that means I want to apply associative, and Abelian property will get this equation, from this I am taking a common out, apply distributive law property, if I apply this, we will get this. So a times of u plus v equal to this, right? If you similar a prime times of this equal to you get this. So if I take it like this, you can write here. So this, which is nothing but 0 by star. This is nothing but 0 from star. Star, what I am taking here? X1 plus y1 plus 2z1 0 0. X2 plus y2 plus 2z equal to 0. I am writing this in star here, that equal to 0. That means x plus 2yz2, that means this element satisfies this condition. Therefore, au plus bv, that element belongs to w. So a comma belongs to R and u comma belongs to W, which implies a u plus b belongs to W. Therefore, W is subspace of vectors. Okay, W is vector subspace of R2 over R. Can vector subspace of R2 over R also. Show that the solutions of differential equation d square plus 5d, d square minus 5d plus 6y equal to 0 is subspace of vector space of real numbers, real valued continuous functions of over R. Okay. I want to show that the solution of this differential equation is the subspace of the vector space of all real valued continuous function over R. So, given vector space is C over R, be a vector space of set of all continuous real valued functions, okay, or continuous function whatever over R. And W is equal to y such that d square minus 5d plus 6y equal to 0. This is given W. I want to show that this W is vector subspace of this vector, right? Let C or be a vector space, I am taking that. This is set of all continuous function over real over the field R. C over nothing but F such that F R to R is continuous function. I am taking F comma G belongs to W, which implies D square minus 5D, F equal to 0. Why? Because if I take any element in W, which are in the form like this, which satisfies this condition. If I take g plus w, which also satisfies this condition. Okay. Now what can I do? I want to take two elements in our field, a comma b belongs to R and a plus b g belongs to R also. Okay. A comma belongs to R. I want to show that a plus b g belong into W for this, which are satisfy this condition. So I want to take that f comma g plus w and a comma belongs to R. I am considering each element a plus b g. So for being that a plus bg belongs to w, I want to verify that d square minus 5d plus 6 times of a plus equal to 0. If I get this equal to 0, we say that this element is in w. Considering, I am considering that d square minus 5d plus 6 a plus bg. D square times of a plus bg minus 5d a plus bg plus 6 times of a plus bg according to properties of differential equation. So, which is nothing but d square of a plus d square of bg, 5d minus af, 5d minus bg, and 6af, 6af. So, that equal to what we had, d square af plus b d square g, and 5d square f minus 5dg, 6af, 6bg. From this, I am taking common out a, why because this element of set of all continuous functions, which has satisfied, why because since c over a vector space, we can common out a area. I apply the all properties of vector space, that means associative identity, Abelian property. From this, I will take a comma out 5d square f minus 5df plus 6f. If I take b comma out d square g minus 5dg plus 6g. This is nothing but already you know that you can take f here, d square minus 3 plus 6f. If I take g here, d square minus 5d plus 6g. This thing already you know that 0 and this thing already you know 0, that means au is equal to 0. 0 plus 0 that equal to 0. Therefore, this is satisfied d square minus 5d plus 6f plus 6bg equal to 0. This is satisfies given condition. Therefore, a plus bg plus w for all a comma b belongs to R, f comma g belongs to W. Therefore, the solutions of different equation d square minus 5d plus 6 0 is subspace of the vector space of all real valued continuous function over R. So now I'm taking the next problem. V is the vector space 2 by 2 matrices over the field F. Show that W is not a subspace of V, where W is equal to first one, A belongs to V, such that dT A equal to 0. Second one, W is equal to A belongs to V, such that A square equal to A. Let to V over B a vector space of 2 by 2 matrices. W is equal to A belongs to V, such that dT A equal to 0. V over B a vector space of all 2 by 2 matrices. So I'm taking that V over B a vector space of 2 by matrices. I want to say W is not subspace of W is equal to this, right? First of all, I want to take that W is equal to A belongs to V, dT A equal to 0. So for showing that dT A belongs to 0, that means let V over B a vector space of 2 by 2 matrices. First one, W is equal to A belongs to V, such that dT A equal to 0. Second one, let A equal to 16, 0, 0, 0. But because dT A equal to 0, dT A equal to 0, that element belongs to W. So that means this element belongs to W. Second one, I am taking that B equal to this also dT A. dT B equal to 0. These two elements belongs to W. I want to show that dT A plus B. For showing that W is subspace of a vector space, I know two properties. One property is alpha comma beta belongs to W, which implies alpha plus beta belongs to W. And A comma alpha belong, A belongs to F, alpha belongs to V, W, then which implies A alpha belongs to W. That's why I'm using this first property easily. A plus beta. A plus B. A plus B is equal to 16, 0, 0. That equals this. The value 16, 0, 0. Dt A plus B equal what happens? 16, 0, 0. That is 256, which is not equal to 0. A comma B belongs to W, but A plus B does not belong into W. Therefore, W is not subspace of V. W is not subspace of V. That means W is not satisfies closure property with respect to addition. Therefore, it is not a subspace of V. Second one, W is equal to A belongs to V, such that A square equal to. I am taking I is equal to 1, 0, 0. That means I square equal to this, where I square equal to I. 16 belongs to F. 16i equal to what happened here? 16i 0 0 0, that equal to 16 0 0 0. So 16 a square equal to I'm taking one element to this element belongs to W and 16 belongs to F. That means a alpha, I want to show that a alpha for this thing, right? 16i equal to what happened? 256 0 0, 256, 256, so 1 0 0. That we get 260, 256 in pi. That means a square not equal to 16i is equal to what we get here? 16 0 0. I want to get here 16 0 0, a square equal to a, but I am getting is different, 256 0 0. That means 16i square is not equal to 16i, it is 256i. Therefore, it is not satisfied, a square is not equal to a. Therefore, W is not subspace of V. Let W subspace of, sorry, I am taking another problem. Let W is subspace of C3, which of the following are subspace of C3. I am taking that W is subset of C3, which of the following are subspaces of C3. So W is equal to what happening here? W is equal to alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, such belongs to C3, such that alpha 1 is real. Next, alpha 1, alpha 2 belongs to C3, where alpha 1 equal to 0, alpha 2 equal to 0. Either alpha 1 equal to 0 or alpha 2 equal to 0. First of all, I am taking that C3 over C is a vector space. W is equal to alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 belong to C3, such that alpha 1 is real. I am taking that U is equal to 1, 1 belongs to, simply I am taking one element belongs to W. So I am taking I belonging to C. I is equal to F W. I is equal to what happened? I into 1, 1, 1, that equal to I. But this element does not belong into see each I. Here my taking that my W is how it is look like alpha 1 is real. But here if I multiply that here my I alpha one equal to I does not belong into R. That means this inside element does not belong to R, which implies IU does not belong to W. Therefore, W is not subspace of C3. Second one, I am taking that W is equal to alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 belongs to C3, such that either alpha 1 equal to 0, either R, alpha 2 equal to 0. I want to verify that whether this vector space or subspace of V or not. C3 or U is equal to 0, 1, 1 belong to, this is W. V is equal to 1, 0, 0, 1 belongs to W. See, either alpha 1, 0, this is alpha 1, 0, either alpha 2, 0, this is alpha 0. And then U plus V is equal to what happened? 0, 1, 0 plus 1, 0, 0, that equal to 1, 1, 1, 2. So, I verify that one condition, U plus alpha. That means first condition for verifying W plus is alpha plus beta belongs to W. Alpha gamma beta belongs to W and alpha plus beta belongs to W. Next one is A belongs to F, alpha belongs to F, W, which implies A alpha belongs to W. These two properties I want to verify. For that, I want to verify one U plus V belongs to that. U plus equal what happened? 0, U nothing but 0, 1, 1. V nothing but 1, 0, 1. If I add two things, what happened here? 1, 1, 2 belongs to W. But alpha 1 not equal to 0 and alpha 2 is not equal to 0. Therefore, W is not subspace of C3. So, I am verifying that these two subset are not subspace of C3. Yeah, so theorems. Intersection of two subspaces of a vector space is subspace. Intersection of two subspaces of vector space is intersection of two subspaces of a vector space is subspace. Proof. Let V over A be a vector space. I want to prove that intersection of two subspaces. I am taking let W1 over F and W2 over F are two subspaces of V over F. Okay. These two subspaces, I want to take that W1 over F and W2 over F are two subspaces of V over F. Since W1 comma W2 are vector spaces, this has a zero element, singleton zero, and this has a zero element. That means this element, these sets have some elements. Therefore, W1 and W2 is non-empty. Why? Because two subspaces, so vector space nothing but it has at least one zero element. So, I am taking that these both are non-empty. So, it has element, that means W1 and W2 has at least one element that equals singleton zero. I am taking that this is non-empty. It has some elements. So, W1 is subspace of V over F. By theorem, I want to use that AU plus DV belongs to W1 for all A comma V belongs to F and U comma V belongs to W1. First is W1 subspace of U or F, which implies you can write yes. See, all right, I know that W2 is also subspace of U or F, which implies it may be written as AU plus DV belongs to W for all A comma belongs to F, U comma V belongs to W. By using theorem only, I am writing here. Since A comma belongs to F, U comma V belongs to W1 comma W2, which implies what happened A comma belongs to F and U comma V belongs to W1 to W2. Because U comma belongs to W1 to W2, this element also W1. But AU plus BU plus W1 and AU plus DU plus W2 already from 1 and 2, which implies what happened? This element plus W1 and this element of W2, which implies what happened? AU plus BU also belong to W1 W2 for all A comma belongs to F and U comma U belongs to W1 intersection W2. Therefore, W1 intersection W is a subspace of U over F. That means, so intersection of two subspaces of vector space is a again subspaces of V over F. You have to remember this theorem. It is interest also very important, right? So finitely family of intersection of subspace of vector space is a subspace. Finitely family of intersection of subspace of a vector space is a subspace. Before I am taking two subspaces, if I take finite number of and let V over F be a vector space, W1 comma W2 comma W and R subspace of V over F. This one. WI are subspace, so that means it is a vector space, it has singleton zero element. Therefore, intersection of W1 is empty set, non-empty set. It has some element that equals singleton zero, since these are vector spaces. Let W subspace of U over F, which implies AU belongs to AU plus BU plus W1, which are all A comma belongs to F and U comma belongs to W1. Let W2 subspace of U over F, that means AU plus W2 for all A comma belongs to F and U comma belongs to W2, since because W subspace. That as W1 is subspace of U over F, that means implies so AU plus BV belongs to W1 and A comma, or all A comma belongs to F and U comma belongs to W1. let I am taking A comma belongs to F and U comma belongs to W1 comma W2 comma Wn, which implies what happen? A comma belongs to F comma U comma V belongs to intersection of all this I equal to 1 to n. That means this U comma belongs to W1 intersection, W2 intersection, data W1 intersection. But see, if this element belongs to W, then what we know that A comma belongs to F and U comma belongs to W1, W2, that means this all AU plus BV plus W1 and AU plus BV plus W2, that is AU plus BV and WN. So this all element of W1, which implies what happens, AU plus BV belongs to set of all intersection, that means W1 intersection, W2 intersection, W, that means intersection I equal to 1 to N, WN. So for all, A comma B belongs to F, U comma belongs to WN, what happen? So this AU plus BU and intersection this. So therefore W1 I equal to 1 to N intersection, WI intersection, that means W1 intersection, W data, WN intersection is the subspace of U over F. Okay. So we have proved the theorem. Union of two subspaces of vector space is not subspaces. We should already prove that. Intersection of two subspaces is subspace, but union of two subspaces of a vector space is not a subspace. So, for example, I am taking V3 over R, that equal to R3 over R, is a vector space. W1 equal to X 0 0 such that X belongs to R, subspace belongs to V3, is a vector space. Okay, no doubt. W2 is equal to 0 Y 0 belongs to subset of V3. This is also vector space. You can easily prove that, already I explained in last lecture. W1 union W2, that equal to what happened, x comma 0 comma 0 union 0 comma y comma 0 such that x comma y plus R, which is not subset of V3. So that means so why? Because this, if I take that W1 union W2, W1 nothing but X 0 0 union, W nothing but 0 Y 0, so is that X comma will not sure. Okay. You can take that for two elements in the set. If you apply this property, so that means if I take two elements in the set, X comma, that means elements of this form, either in this form or this form only. If you take one element like this, you can take x comma 0 comma 0. That means all elements in the form either x comma 0 comma 0 union 0 comma y only. But if I take this element, if I add this thing, what you will get either the extra element to x 0 or x y 0, like this you will get. That means this set only contains an element either from this or this. But our element will get here x y 0. That's why that element does not belong to W1. Therefore, W1 union W2 is not subspaces of R3. Theorem. Let W1 comma W2 are two subspaces of vector space V over F. The necessary and sufficient condition for W1 union W2 is subspace of V over F is W1 W2 sorry W1 is subset equal to W2, either this or W2 intersection W2 subset equal to W2. So what theorem have we have to prove here? W1 comma W2 or two subspaces of vector space U or F, the necessary sufficient condition for W1 union W2 is subspace of U or F is either one is contained in other W1 subspace W2 or W2 subspace W1. You may define other way also. Let W1 comma W2 or two subspaces of vector space U or F, list of W1 union W2 is subspace of U or F, you find only W1 subspace equal to W2 or W2 subspace equal to W1. Proof. Let W1 comma W2 are two subspaces of U over F. Sufficient condition that let W1 subset equal to W2 or W2 subset equal to W1. I am taking this. So next I want to show that first of all I am taking here W1 comma W2 are two subspaces of U over F. I am taking this. Sufficient condition I am taking here W1 subset equal to W2 or W2 subset equal to W1. If W1 subset equal to W1. Okay. Which implies what happened? W1 union W2 is equal to what happened W2. Why? Because W2 is big set. W1 subscribe W2. If I take union W1 union W2 is equal to W2, is subspace of that equal to W2. Already know that W2 is subspace of U or F. That means W1 union W2 is subspace of U or F. If I take W subscribe equal to W1, which implies what happened? W1 union W2 is equal to W1. W1 union, W2 is equal to W1. Already we know that W1 subspace of URF, W nothing but W1 union W2, therefore W1 union W2 is the subspace of URF. So one property is over. Next set condition. Play to W1 union W2 is subspace of URF I am taking. If possible, I want to show that W1 subspace to W2 or W subspace to W1. I want to prove here Kondratiev label. If possible, W1 subscribe equal to W2 or W subscribe equal to W1 I am taking here. Let W1 subscribe equal to W2. I am taking first one is W1 subscribe equal to W2. Which implies what happened, which nothing but there exists an element in W1, there exists X belong to W1 such that this X does not belong to W2. Why? Because W1 not subscribe equal to W nothing but it has some more element other than this element. That means this set has some extra element, that element does not belong to this. So that's why I am taking that. There exists an element in W1 such that X does not belong to W2. That element does not even contain in this set. There exists X belong to W1 such that X belongs to W2. So this you can put one. If I take W2 subscribe to W1, W2 is not subscribed equal to W1. That means this set has some extra element, that element does not belong, that does not in W1. That means there exists Y belongs to W2 such that Y belongs to W2. You can put 1, 2. So these are crucial. One belongs to 2. Right, I am taking that X comma Y belongs to W1 union W2. Why? Because X belongs to W1 and X Y belongs to W2. X comma Y belongs to compulsory it belongs to W1 union W2. That means so X is either in W1 or Y in W2. That point to this implies X comma Y belonging to W1 union W2. That means from this we can have X, which implies X also belongs to W1 and W2. This belongs to Y2, which implies Y belongs to W1 union W2. So for that I am taking here, let X comma Y belongs to W1 union W2, which implies X plus Y belongs to W1 union W2, since closure property. Why? Because W1 union W2 I am taking that is subspace satisfies vector space property. That means it is closure property. I am taking that X plus Y belongs to W1 union W2, which implies X plus Y belongs to W1 or X plus Y belongs to W2. If X plus Y belongs to W1 in W2, nothing but this element either in W1 or in W2. X plus Y that equal to W1 or X plus Y belongs to W2. Let alpha equal to what I am taking here, X plus Y, and beta equal to X. I am taking two elements in W1 because this element in W1, this element in W2, so that's why I am taking alpha equal to X plus Y and beta equal to X. A equal to 1 and beta equal to minus 1 belongs to F. For showing W1 is a vector subspace, I want to show that A alpha plus B beta belongs to W. That's why I am taking here A equal to 1, B equal to minus 1 belongs to F. W1 subspace of URF, which implies A alpha plus B beta belongs to W1. This side, you know. A equal to how much here? 1 times alpha nothing but X plus Y. B equal to how much here? Minus 1. Beta nothing but 1. So, 1 into X plus Y minus 1 into X. That equal to X plus Y minus X. So, by apply here, what can I do? So from this, I want to apply associate property, next Abelian property. Then what will get here? X minus X plus Y, which nothing but X minus X plus 0, that equal to X minus X plus 0, that equal to Y. Associative, next to Abelian property, apply, will get this. From this, you can apply associate property, X minus X equal to 0. X minus X equal to 0 by inverse property, X minus X equal to 0 plus Y, that equal to Y. That means, so, X plus Y minus X equal to Y, Y belongs to W1. Let I am taking X plus Y belongs to W2, Y belongs to W2, alpha equal X plus Y, beta equal to Y belongs to W2, and A equal to 1, beta equal to minus 1. You can do same thing, 1 into X plus Y minus 1 into Y, X plus Y minus Y that equal to X plus Y minus Y, X minus 0 that equal to X, so X plus W2. So, from 3 and 4 can observe here, our statement 1 says that Y does not belong to W1, our statement 4. Here statement of 3, 2 says that X does not belong to W2. See, our already taken that here. You can observe, quickly observe here. X belongs to W1, but X does not belong to W2. Y belongs to W2, but Y does not belong to W2. Sorry. There exists W2, Y does not belong to W1 here. This is W1. So, from using from 1 and 2, that what happened? X does not belong to W2, but we are getting X belongs to W2. y does not belong into W1, but we are getting y belongs W1. So this is contradicts to 1 and 2. That means our supposition is wrong. Our taken supposition is wrong. So equation 3 and 4 is contradiction to equation 1 and equation 2. Our assumption is wrong. Therefore, W1 sub star equal to W2 or W sub star equal to W. We are assuming that W1 sub star not equal to W2. W2 is not sub star equal to W1. But if I take like this, we are getting contradiction proof. That's why I am writing here. W1 is not sub star equal to W2 or W2 is not sub star equal to W2. Hence, proved theorem. Union of two subspace of vector space is subspace defined only if one is contained in other. Union of two subspace of vector space is a subspace defined only if one is contained in other. One is contained in other. So next, linear sum. Okay. So what is linear sum? Let U or be vector space and W1 comma W2 are two subspaces of vector space U over F. Okay, I'm taking that. Let U or F is a vector space and W1 comma W2 are two subspaces of U over F. Then the set U1 plus W2 such that U1 plus W1 comma U2 plus W2 is called inner linear sum. Is called linear sum of two subspaces of W1. It is denoted by W1 comma W2. Therefore, W1 plus W2 is equal to U1 plus U, such that U1 belongs to W1 and U2 belongs to W1. This U1 belongs to W2, right? So that means, here if I take linear sum nothing but it is look like addition only. That means your first element belongs to W1, second element to W2. So this set is called linear sum of two subspaces of W1 and W2. So, okay, example. I am taking this V3, right? V3 is equal to R over R, W1 equal to X0, 0, X belongs to R, W2 is equal to 0, Y0, so Y belongs to R, W1 plus W is equal to, this is subspace and this is subspace, and I am writing here X plus Y, X plus nothing but this element plus this element, that equal to, you can write here, first element belongs to W1, second element belongs to W2. So W1 plus W equal to X, Y, 0 such that X comma Y comma Y belongs to 1. So W1 is equal to R over Q and W2 over equal to Q over Q. W1 plus W equal to R over Q plus Q over Q. So these are two subspaces of C over Q. That means U1 plus U such that E1 belongs to R and Q1 belongs to R. This is a linear sum of two subspaces. Some theorem on linear sum. Okay. Let W1 comma W2 are two subspaces of vector space U over F. Then linear sum W1 plus W2 is subspaces of V over F. Second one is W1 subset equal to W1 plus W2 and W2 is subset equal to W1 plus W2. You can observe here W1 comma W2 are two subspaces of vector space U over F. Then the linear sum W1 plus W2 is subspace of U over F. Second one, W1 subscribe to W1 plus W2 and W subscribe equal to W1 plus W2. Later, I am taking that W1 comma W2 are two subspace of U over F. The linear sum W of W1 W is defined as W1 plus W2 such that U1 plus U2 such that U1 plus W1 and U2 plus W1. This is small U1, small U2. Later, I am taking that alpha is equal to I am taking that alpha is equal to U1 plus U2 where U1 alpha equal to U1 plus U2 W1 plus W2 beta equal to U1 plus V2 plus W1 plus W2 where U1 comma U1 plus W1 and U2 comma V2 belongs to W2. Let W is a space of U over F which is nothing but A1 plus B1 plus W1 and for all A comma belongs to F, U1 belongs to W1 by because W subspace property you can write easily here A1 plus U1 W1 for all A comma belongs to F and U1 comma V1 belongs to W1. Let W2 is subspace of U over F which implies AU2 plus BV2 belongs to W2 for all A comma belongs to F and U1 U2 comma V2 belongs to W2. Okay. So consider A R complex D beta. For showing that W1 plus W subspace, I want to this show that this element will be W1. AU plus V1 I'm considering. AU plus V nothing but what happened? A times of U1 plus U2 plus V times of V1 plus V2, which equal to AU1 plus AU2 plus BV1 plus BV2. How you write here? It's nothing but AU1, first you write AU1 plus AU2 and BV1 plus BV2. Next, apply associate property and equivalent property. We will get here AU1 plus AU2, that BV1 plus B2 is nothing but AU1 B1. We can apply associate property. You can apply associate property here. Next, we can apply equivalent property. We will get BV1 comes this side, AU2 comes this side. Next, we can apply associate property. So, we will get AU1 plus B1 because since our W1 counter vector is subspace, that's why I'm applying here this element, right? So we write AU1 plus BV1 plus AU2 plus BV2. From this, you can take here, right here. Since this element belongs into W1, this element belongs to W2. From here, you can observe here. This element belongs to W2. First of all, first equation 1, this element W2. So this two elements belong to W2. So therefore, this A alpha plus B beta belongs into W1 plus W2. So therefore, which implies what happened, A alpha plus B belongs to W1 plus W2 for all A comma belongs to F and alpha comma beta belongs to W1 plus W2. Therefore, W1 plus W2 is subspace of V over F. Second one, let U1 belong to W1, 0 belongs to W2, and again, I want to show that W1 subscribe W2 subscribe W1 or W1 subscribe for W1 plus W2 or W2 subscribe for W1. I'm writing that thing, right? So I'm writing that U1 belongs to W1, 0 bar belongs to W2. U1 plus 0 bar, that equal to what happened? This element belongs to W1, this element belongs to, if I add this thing, this element belonging to W1 plus W2. U1 plus 0 nothing but U1, this element belongs to W1 plus W2. U1 plus W1, which implies what happened? U1 belongs to W1 plus W2, which implies, you can write here, W1 is also equal to W1 plus W2. Next, I am taking that, let 0 bar belongs to W2, comma U2 belongs to W2, which implies 0 plus U2 belongs to W1 plus W2, according to definition of linear sum. These two elements belong to W1. 0 plus U2, you could write as U2, by because identity property can apply here. This element belongs to W1 plus W2. That means, U2 belongs to W2 and U2 belongs to, which implies what we get here, U2 belongs to W1 plus W2, which implies W2 is equal to W. So, hence, proved the theorem, linear sum theorem. Yeah. Next, let viewer be a set of all functions from R to R, SE be the set of all even functions, and S0 be the set of all odd functions, then show that SE common S0 or subspace of U or A. Second one, SE plus S0 equal to V. Third one, SE intersection S0 equal to singleton 0 bar. So V is set of all functions from R to R. SE is set of all even function, S0 is set of all odd function. So, and I want to prove that SE comma SD are subspace of U or F and SE plus S0 equal to V. SE intersection S0 equal to singleton 0. Right, I am taking that. V is the set of all functions from R to R. That means V is equal to what happened? F such that F R to R is a function. Second one, SE is set of all even functions from R to R. Therefore, SE equal to what happened? F such that F of minus X is equal to F of X. So, even function is equal to what happened? A function F is set to be a function. If F of minus X is equal to F of X, that's why I am writing this, f such that, f auto such that, f of minus is equal to f of. S0 is set of all odd function from R to R such that, nothing but a function f is set to be odd function if can written as f of minus is equal to minus f of x. So, this SE is not. First one I am taking, let f comma g belongs to S0, SE. That means, if two function belongs to SE, which satisfies this condition, f of minus is equal to f of x and g of minus is equal to g of x. Let a comma belongs to R. Consider a plus bg of minus x. If this will get a plus bg of x, then we feel that this is the even function. A plus bg of minus x equal to, you can pass ए एफ ऑफ माइनस एक्स, बी जी ऑफ माइनस एक्स, ए एफ ऑफ माइनस एक्स नथिंग बट एफ ऑफ एक्स, बी जी एफ ऑफ माइनस एक्स इक्वल टू जी ऑफ एक्स फ्रॉम हियर, एफ ऑफ माइनस इक्वल टू एफ ऑफ एक्स, जी ऑफ माइनस इक्वल टू जी ऑफ एक्स, दैट इज इक्वल टू जी ऑफ एक्स. फ्रॉम हियर यू कैन टेक कॉमन आउट टू ए एफ प्लस बी जी ऑफ एक्स, बोथ यू कैन टेक ए एफ प्लस बी जी एफ, ए एफ ऑफ एक्स प्लस बी जी ऑफ एक्स, फ्रॉम यू कैन टेक एक्स ऑन, दैट मीन्स ए एफ प्लस बी जी ऑफ एक्स, दैट मीन्स ए एफ प्लस बी जी ऑफ माइनस एक्स इक्वल टू ए एफ प्लस बी जी ऑफ एक्स. सो दिस एलिमेंट ए एफ प्लस बी जी बिलोंग टू ए सी, देयरफॉर ए एफ प्लस बी जी ऑफ एक्स बिलोंग टू ए सी, फॉर ऑल ए कॉमन बिलोंग्स टू आर एंड ए कॉमन जी बिलोंग्स टू ए सी, देयरफॉर ए सी इज ए सबस्पेस ऑफ वी ओवर एफ. सो यू कैन ए आर प्लस बी बीटा इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ए आर प्लस बी बीटा ओनली, सो आई एम राइटिंग ए एफ प्लस बी जी सिंस फंक्शंस. ओके, बगाड़ इन थ्योरम आई प्रूव दैट ए एफ प्लस बी जी बिलोंग्स टू एफ. Next, I want to show that AC is subspace of. Okay, now I'm taking that let F comma G belongs to AC naught. Same, I want to show that this is A plus BG belongs. That means A alpha plus BD belongs to S naught. Like that, I'm taking here F of S naught, F belongs to S naught nothing but F of minus is equal to minus F of X. G belongs to S naught nothing but G of minus is equal to minus G of X. Let I'm taking that A comma belongs to R. Consider A plus BG of minus X equal to A of minus X plus BG of minus X. A f of minus x and b g of minus x. F of minus x nothing but minus f of x. B g of minus x nothing but g of minus x nothing but minus g of x. Here we write here minus a f of x minus g f of x. Already proved some theorems and there a minus u a of minus u is equal to minus a u. That's already proved in theorems vector space lecture 2, lecture 3. You can observe that equal to minus a f minus b g of x. So you can take minus amount here a f minus bj, therefore this equal to what we get a f plus bg of minus is equal to minus a f bj, therefore this a f plus bg of minus is belongs to s naught for all a comes belongs to r and f comes g belongs to s naught, therefore a c is a subspace of v over f, right. Second one, a c s naught r subspace of v over f. I want to show that this is equal to be a c plus s naught is also subspace of v over f. Just now we proved that W1 comma W2 is subspace of URF, which implies W1 to W2 is subspace of URF. Just now we proved the linear sum of two subspaces is subspace of URF. Just now we proved the previous theorem. That's why we are writing AC comma H0 subspace of URF, which implies AC plus H0 is also a subspace of URF, which implies AC plus H0 subspace of URF, because the subspace of URF, then I want to show that this is okay. It is clearly one. I am putting this one AC plus H0 subspace of URF. I am considering that HE is equal to HE of X, that equal to 1 by 2 F of X plus F of minus X. I am considering this set. H naught of HE of minus X equal to, can be observed here. I am putting here minus X, that equal to 1 by 2 F of minus X plus F of X. That means 1 by 2 HE F of X plus F of minus X. If I put X equal to minus 1 minus here, what happened here? Minus X, minus of minus equal to F of X. HE of minus x equal to HE naught of x, right? Therefore, HE of minus x equal to HE of x. Therefore, HE of x belongs to AC. This element belongs to AC. I'm taking H naught of x, that equal to 1 by 2 F of x equal to minus F of minus x. H naught of minus x equal to, I'm writing 1 by 2 F of minus x, in place of x subtracting minus x, minus of F of, in place of x subtracting what will be F of x only. So, since yeah, from this I am take count minus, then what happen? Minus 1 by 2 f of x minus f of minus x. This nothing but h naught of x. I defined the h naught of x. This nothing but h naught of x. Then h naught h of minus x equal to minus h naught of x. Therefore, h naught of minus x equal to minus h naught of x. Therefore, h naught of x is belonging to s naught. Let I am considering f of x equal to 1 by 2 f of x plus f of minus x plus 1 by 2 f of x minus f of x naught. This element belongs to h naught. This element belongs to s naught. This h naught, this is h naught. So that means f of x is the form of h naught, h of x plus h of naught. This element belongs to h. That means f belongs to v, which implies this element belongs to v. That you could write, I am writing f of x for simply can that 1 by 2 f of x, 1 by 2 f of x is equal to f of x. This f of x, this f of x gets cancelled out. So you can observe here f of minus x and f of minus x. Here minus times of f of minus 1 by x, 1 by 2 x is plus times of this and this cancel out. what we get, f of x plus f of x by 2. That means here 1 by 2, 1 by 2, f of, that is equal to f of x. F of x written as the x, that is so belongs to f. So nothing but this is h naught fx, this element belongs to h naught of x. So f of f belongs to which implies what we get here, f belongs to se plus h naught. From this is, I am writing, this is v subscribe equal to se plus h naught. This is 2. Now one says that v subscribe equal to s is not s subscribe v. 2 says that v subscribe equal to s naught. Therefore, from 1 and 2, what I am writing here, v is equal to se naught, se plus s naught. So second is true. Third one, SE intersection is not. So f of such that f of x minus x equal to f of x and f of minus x equal to f of x. From both you can write here f of minus x equal to f of x and f of minus x equal to minus f of x. This is f of x, this f of x I am writing here minus f of x equal to f of x. See here I am writing here f of minus x equal to f of x, f of minus x equal to minus f of x. In place of f of x, I am substituting, I am writing this f of minus x. Yeah, I'm ready. You can take that. This or you can take that is f of x, keep it like this. F of minus x nothing but what is f of minus x nothing but minus f of x. Minus f of x. So this minus f of x equal to f of x. So this minus f of x comes this side or adding both sides f of x, then what happened? 2 f of x equal to 0 bar. So adding both sides f of minus f of x equal to 0 bar. So that because identity inverse property satisfies 0 bar f of x, 2 f of x will get here. 2 f of x nothing but f of x equal to 0 bar. Therefore, SE intersection S naught equal to singular. That means f, I found that if I take like this, SE intersection S naught, that means if I take any vector in this form, it is both even and odd. That means if I, which set, which function is satisfied, only 0 function satisfies even and odd. Therefore, SE intersection S naught equal to 0 bar. So, this end the lecture. Thank you for watching this. This led to XLFY. So, on theorems of theorems of and problems of vector subspace.